the dreams and the imaginations disturb the Mooladhara Chakra. Mooladhara is disturbed by the load of your imaginations. See, when you understand this one idea, only this one idea, nothing else is necessary. This one chakra is enough. You can come out of the 80% of the problems. The energy of your being, 80% of your energy will be completely released. It will be available to you for the use. 80% of our energy is just blocked because of this one chakra. Not because of anything else, just because of this one chakra. If this one chakra is opened, if this one chakra is touched, if this one chakra is energized, 80% of your energy will be available to the creativity. Otherwise, all the energy will be blocked in the imaginations. All the energy will be blocked in the images, image collecting. If only this thing can be understood. And if you know how to burn the images which you have collected on the Mooladhara, you will see 80% of your energy is available for creativity. It will be available for your business. It will be available for your art. It will be available for your life. It will be available for your reality. So, this is the chakra, which needs a beautiful, deep understanding and a powerful meditation technique. To awaken this chakra is given by Shiva, to burn the images which we have collected in Mooladhara, to live with the reality. See, Bob, not only with the wife, with the family members, people have got imagination. Many people have got the imagination, even with the gurus. Many people come to meet me. Before they come and meet me, they have heard a lot about me. They listen that this Swami can heal, this Swami can give life, this, that, many things they listen. When they listen everything, they imagine about me with a big beard, an elderly man sitting on a throne. They imagine all these things. When they come to, really it has happened many times, they hear about me, and when they come to meet me without seeing me photograph, they simply feel that they are at loss, they are shocked. Once it really happened when I was sitting outside the ashram. Once I was sitting outside the ashram, and a pipe, there was a big water pipe, and that I was sitting and shaking my legs and relaxing the evening air. One man came and asked, "I want to meet Swamiji." I told him, "You go and sit in the meditation hall. He will come. It is time for his darshan. He will come." When he went and sat, after some time, I washed myself and got ready. I went to the meditation hall. The hall is, in the hall there is no my photograph. I went to the hall to sit on my simhasana, to sit on my peetam. When I went and sat on the peetam, he told me, "No, I want to meet the big Swamiji." I told him, "No, I am the big Swamiji." No, he says, no, I want to meet Swamiji who does healing and all. I heard that he does lot of healing. I want to meet that Swamiji who went and wandered all over India. I heard about him, that I want to meet that Swamiji. I told him, "You see, I cannot have an identity card. If you believe that I am that Swami, please come. I will talk to you and I will do what can be done. If you can't, what can be done?" And you won't believe that man went away. Really, he went away. And people are coming with such a prejudiced idea, such that they already collected images, they already created their own thing in mind. They are not able to digest the reality. So it is, you see, creating image, imagination and projecting it is such a hard thing, such a strong thing. It needs tremendous intelligence to live with the reality. Most of the time we miss the reality. We look at the reality in a distorted way. See, you wear a green glass. If you wear a green glass and look at the world, how it will look? Green. And not even a green glass. The glass is broken here and there. And you are looking through that glass. What will happen? whole world will look like a startup thing. That is the way we look at this world. That is the way we see the reality. That is the reason we feel God is not doing justice to us. See, God is the energy which can do so much, not only the, which is doing everything. See, we believe that God can do everything, but only thing, we don't believe God has got enough buddhi to do everything. See, we believe God has got shakti to do everything. We know that God has got shakti to give what we want, but we don't believe God has got buddhi to when to give. That is what is our problem. We believe he has got shakti, but we don't believe he has got buddhi. The same way, we just project our own things on the others. The projection and the imagination is what locks this chakra. And the tremendous energy, more than 80% of your energy is just locked and hanging on this chakra. If you can be released at this chakra, you will see that unemptiable or the perennial source of energy is touched by your life, by your being. There is a technique by Shiva in Tantra to awaken the Muladhara Chakra. This is a highly powerful technique which directly touches the Kundalini and awakens the energy centers of our body. This is a very powerful technique. When your imaginations are burnt completely, your miseries are burnt. You will have no more problem. Many people come and tell me, "Swamiji, I love my wife. That is the reason I'm older." Never, never, never tell that lie. You see, there is a two thing. One is wife, another one is mold. If you love the wife, you will change the mold. You love the mold, that is the reason you change the wife. You understand? If you love the wife, you will never change the wife, you will change the mold. You are loving the mold, that is the reason? Change the wife. Never say that I love her because I love her, I change her. No. This is a powerful technique to burn all the imaginations, to give you the clarity and accept, welcome the other as they are. Accept and welcome the life as it is. Enjoy the reality as it is. It's a beautiful technique. To awaken the energy of the Muladhara. You see, if the Muladhara is awakened, you will accept the reality. If you accept the reality, Muladhara will be awakened. It will be like a chain. Any chakra has to be awakened with understanding. You see, there should be two things in your life. Maturity and meditation, both. Only meditation will do nothing. There are many people whom you can see from morning till night, they sit in the puja room and meditate. As soon as they come out, they jump like a bomb on others. Somebody came and asked me, "Swamiji, what puja should I do? I wanted peace in my house, happiness in my house. What puja should I do?" I told her, "You see, first thing, all of you sit with each other, laugh, joke, understand each other. That's the first puja you should do." She told me, no, I am already doing Varalakshmi puja. Should I do Vaibhav Lakshmi puja also? What puja should I do? What vrata should I do?" I told her, "You see, when you enter into the puja room, you do puja to the Lakshmi. When you come out of the puja room, you do archana to your husband. Puja to your Lakshmi, archana to your husband. How can peace exist in your house? How can this thing happen in the real life?" So simply meditating will do nothing. Meditation and maturity, both should have in your life, and both should go hand in hand. Then only you will see the transformation in your life. Or when you close your eyes, you will be sitting and meditating. When you open your eyes, you jump on everybody and bite. That is not the way of real life. That is a pseudo-spirituality. I call that as a pseudo-spirituality. You will enter into the technique. now, please all of you get ready.